This video is an introduction to using load steps in the ANSYS solver. Let's start by loading the ANSYS user profile. Now that the ANSYS user profile is loaded, we need to import a model to work on. Start by clicking on the File option from the menu toolbar. Here we choose the file named chapter22.h. Next, we create some load collectors. To do this, start by right-clicking in the model browser. Choose the highlighted load collector option. Name the first load collector, Constraints. Type Constraints in the name field and then hit Enter. Now we assign a color to the load collector. Here we choose Purple. Since we are going to create more than one load collector, we uncheck the highlighted box. This will save us some time since we won't need to right-click in the model browser to create a new load collector each time. We have assigned a name and color, so now create the load collector. Name this load collector, Force1, then hit Enter. This time, we assign the color blue. Name this load collector, Force2. Then hit Enter. We assign a neon green color this time. Name this load collector, Force3, then hit Enter. This time, we assign the color forest green to the load collector. We are done creating load collectors, so close the Create Load Collector window. Expand the Load Collector folder in the model browser. Now we change the Load Collector, Constraints, to the current Load Collector. We make Constraints current because we would like to modify it. Let's add some constraints to the model. To do this, start by clicking on the BCs option from the menu toolbar. Choose the constraints option as we would like to create constraints. In order to more easily click on the modes we would like to constrain, we are going to zoom into the model. Now we pan the model. We want to constrain the row of nodes on the left edge of the model. Instead of clicking on each node individually, we use the extended selection menu. We select the bypath option. Click on the highlighted corner node. Since we used the bypath option, we click the corner node at the other end of the edge. Doing this will select all the nodes on the path to the newly chosen node, which is exactly what we want in our case. In the Constraints panel, we want all of the DAF options checked. Since this is already the case, and we have the desired node selected, choose the Create option to constrain these nodes. We also want to constrain the row of nodes on the right edge as well, so we pan the model. We are going to use the same method of selecting the nodes as the other edge. So we once again use the bypath option. The desired nodes are selected, so click on the Create to get back to our original view, Click on the highlighted Zoom to Fit icon. Since we are finished constraining the model, exit the Constraints panel. We want to add some forces to the Force 1 load collector, but in order to do this, we need to make it the current load collector. To do this, start by right-clicking on the Force 1 load collector. Choose the Make Current option. Now that the Force 1 load collector is set to current, we can add some forces to it. We would like to change the direction of the force. To do this, click the highlighted drop-down. Here we choose the Z-axis option. We want to change the magnitude of the force, so click on the magnitude field to do this. Type in 500, then hit enter. We also want to change the size of the force. This will not affect the magnitude, but only the graphical representation. Type in 20, then hit enter. Now we select the nodes we want the force to act on. In our case, the nodes at the center of the two bolt holes. Now that the desired nodes have been selected, create the forces. Now we want to add forces to the Force 2 load collector. Just as before, we need to change it to the current load collector. Now that the Force 2 load collector is set to current, we can add forces to. Before we add any forces to the Force 2 load collector, we want to mask the forces from the Force 1 load collector to avoid any confusion in the model. To do this, click on the highlighted icon. Select the left bolt hole node and then choose Create. For the second force, we want to change the magnitude. Type in negative 500, then hit Enter. Now we select the other bolt hole node and then choose Create. Once again we mask the forces just created to avoid confusion. Now we make the Force 3 load collector current. We now add forces to the Force 3 load collector. Select the two bolt hole nodes and then choose create. Now that we are done creating forces, we want to create some load steps. Start by choosing the Setup option from the menu tool. To name the load step, type in Step 1, then hit. Now we add load collectors to the load step. For this load step, we choose Constraints and Force 1. Now create the load step named Step. We would like to create another load step. This time, we call it Step 2. Type in Step 2, then hit Enter. This time, we choose Constraints and Force 2. We call the third load step, Step 3. Type in Step 3, then hit. Choose Constraints and Force 3 this time. Now that we are done creating load steps, exit the load step. Now we expand the load step folder to see the newly created load steps in the model browser. Click on the setup option from the menu toolbar once again. Choose the control card option. The control card panel is opened. Now click on the /SOLU option. This exits the current processor and enters the SOLU processor. Click on the LS Solve button, which stands for Load Step Solve. The Load Step Solver panel is now open. This panel is used to determine which load steps are solved when an analysis is run. The desired values are already entered into the LS Min, LS Max, and LS Inc. fields. The LS min field value is 1. The LS max value is 3 because we created 3 load steps. The LS inc, or increment, field has a value of 1 because we want the solver to go by increments of 1 from the first to third load step. These values will solve all 3 of the load steps we created. Now click the return button to exit the panel. We are done with the control card, so exit the panel. Click on the File option from the menu toolbar. We want to export the solver deck. We do not need to change the file type and template since they are already set to ANSYS and we are using the ANSYS user profile. Now we choose the location of the file we wish to export. We are going to export the solver deck in the ANSYS folder. All we have to do now is name our file. We name our file 4410_export.cdb. Type this in and then hit enter. The file format is .cdb because this is the file format for ANSYS files. Now that the file location and name have been determined, click on Export to export the file. Click on Close to exit the export browser. This concludes our video on the introduction to load steps in ANSYS.